Hi everybody, welcome to HorseRide. Today I am going to guide you how to model a frame and apply our photo and other paint photos. If you are new to the channel, subscribe the channel. You will get whenever I upload the new videos, you will get immediately. Don't skip the video. Always don't skip the video in 3D modeling. It's my suggestion because while modeling, we'll be having several steps which will be useful for you. Main thing, it will be there. In case you have missed that steps, you can't able to understand what's happening in 3D modeling. Let's go to the video. Press Shift A and create a cube. Press 1 on the keyboard for the front view and scale it down. Or we can do one thing, we can give the, I have given in the everything in centimeter. Okay, now what I'm going to give is I'm going to give the height 100 centimeter, x I'm going to give it as 75, and y I'm going to mention it as 10 centimeter. 10 is very high, I feel. I make it as 8. I make it as 4. Yeah, this looks fine. So before that, you can save the file. I save it as photo frame tutorial. I'm just mention photo frame. So here, before go to the other steps, let me add the add-ons. Go to the preference and search for library library. If you put it comes several lists, you have to take material library and 3D view blender kit online asset library. You have to take this both and search for the add-on which is the fast curve. You have to take this one. In case it's not available, I give it in the link description for downloading the fast curve add-on. After downloading, go to install and select the file, select the zip file and click install add-on. It will install. After install, it will show here. You can tick that options. If you are not clear, you can give it in comment. I will guide you. So after doing that, after resizing the images, press here. We can able the scale is the settings dimension is become different. So the scale should be always 1. Press Shift A and click All Transform to reset everything to the required centimeter for us. So now scale has been applied. Go to the edit mode. Select these two faces. Press 1 on the keyboard for the front view. Press I to insert, and I insert like this big frame thickness I am going to give. Press 3 on the keyboard, select this face, front face. Press Shift D, Shift D to duplicate, Y to move. Press P to for the selection, and you can separate this object and name it as press F2, name it as glass and go to the modifier settings, add the modifier called solidify and make it 2 centimeter. Sorry, it's one is very high, so make 0.6 is enough, I feel, for the thickness of the. I make it one more thing, 0.3. yeah, this thickness is enough for the glass. Now select this thing, press F2, make it as frame, select this one, press Shift D and Y, make a duplicate again, press F2 to rename it as photo and close the solidify which is not required for us. Okay, select the frame, go to edit mode, Select these two places, press space on the keyboard and search bridge edge loops. In case while you press the search bar is not coming, means you can change the settings in the preference. Go to the edit and preference key mapping. Here you have the preference are there. Here space bar action default, it will be selected as play. I have selected as search for the search menu. I save it once again. Always save the modifying Blender. What are the things is required for you? Okay. After do this, go to object mode, save it, and here you can able to see after add on, you can able to see fast curve here, bevel the object, and it's showing like it's beveling more for us. Right click and share smooth. Go to the triangle, auto smooth is selected, okay, and make it as 30, no, let it be 60, and let me change the modifier. We can change the, instead of 1 centimeter, 0.3, 0.2, yeah, this looks fine for the corner edges which is required for us. Okay, now we have applied the same. Now what we are going to do in this, we are going to apply a photo for that. For that, we can press N on the keyboard. I hide this both things, selecting this one using shift key, select this. Select this one and using shift key, select this one, both press H to hide. Select this photo frame and create a one more window using this plus key. And go to the UV editor menu, go to tab and select and scale it up. So this is the size which we are going to scale it up for unwrapping. So let it be the same and go to the shader editor, select this object, go to this option, material option, press new on the keyboard, make it as photo. So I'm going to add here two frame, two photos. I'm going to add. I press control space to zoom it, press shift A, search for the image, press control T to open this mapping coordinate. So in case you are not getting this control T option, it's not coming, means go to the preference, search for the one more add-on called Node Wagner. So you have to select all these options for enabling this Node Wagner. After doing that, you can go for the base color is color and open the image. So I open the paint which I have chosen for timing. And here select the repeat to extend, press control space, go to the rendering view. Now you can able to see our image is selected but it's flipped. Here you can able to see, here also it's flipped. What we are going to do is we can go for the UV editor, go to edit mode, select all the faces, press R to rotate, press you can view that how it's coming. Yeah, this is correct. I have rotated back side. Press R to rotate like this. So which is matching the image for us. Using control you can align it correctly. And select this, select it, scale it in X, scale it in Y. Now as per our requirement, its images has been came here for our record. Now our photo is ready. Now you can go for the press Alt H to unhide everything select this front one and the glass one, go to the shader editor, press new, change it to glass BSP shader. I am in the eve rendering mode. Here you have to select ambient occlusion, bloom, screen reflection, refraction, and in material here you have to select screen space refraction. So now we can able to see the glass is become very dull. So we have to increase the down the roughness. Our glass is ready here. And here reflection depth you can make it as 0.5 reflection, and go to this and press 3. Okay, this is the depth, reflection depth. I make it as 10. Yeah, it looks better for us. I select this one and G Y using shift key can zoom it in. And select this photo and this photo, press G Y to move inside the frame, and select both everything, press 1 on the keyboard. Yes to scale using shift key, you can scale it little bit. Okay, now our photo is ready. Now we are going to add a wood frame for this. Here you can able to see one blender asset is here. I remember you once again, go to preference, search for the LIBR for library. This blender kit online asset should be available. It will download the material using online. I search for the wood, I unselect this, and I'm going to give the wood one is 1 I select and drag it for the same, and it will be getting downloaded. When you are in UV edition mode, you are able to see go to edit mode, select all and assign it. So we need to find why it's happening. It's showing like purple. I close this one for timing and I minus this. I apply the new material, add the wood. Select all the things, press GZ to move to up. Send on the keyboard, go to the item, everything scale has been applied. I make it as 1 and enter. Okay, nothing happens. What I'm going to do, I'm going to delete this wood frame. Okay, once again I search for the This is the HDR environment which is required for us. I don't think I download. This is required for us for the purpose to fix it in home. I am downloading this Christmas photos studio. Okay, I am going to the world object here. I delete this and I move this one. I open that and make this Christmas photo and I turn on the studio too. I select this everything, select this, select this, select this, press GY to move towards the this thing, GZ to move here. This background color I'm going to give it a slightly white. Okay, I select this one, I edge, I use, I select this both and GY to move towards the wall. Okay, now I have moved the same. Now I need to apply only the wood texture. Select this one and search for wood texture once again and I download it. We are facing some issues in this. Okay, let me go for the another wood texture which will be suitable for us instead of going the same. Okay, I make it this one and let you try. I downloaded it once again here for this wood. Oops. I select this one and I drag it and put it here. Yeah. Now it's applied. I change the background once again to the material. Okay, fine. This one I'm going to give this one as this one I'm going to change. Go to the render view. This one, select this material and here you can able to see. Go to the object. Here you can able to see many things has been applied. And I'm going to apply the scaling for this. What I am going to do, select this everything, press Ctrl T, Ctrl Z, I make it one thing, press Ctrl T and go to the object and drag it for everything, all the vectors, it should get assigned and I select these two and I just make it as all the things weight 10. Now I make it 20. Okay, now this wood texture frame is updated. Here, after doing this, you can press 0 on the keyboard for the camera angle, press Ctrl space N, and I go to the view and I lock the camera view and I align it for this, because I'm going to add one more frame also here. And press GY. GY to move towards inside. I'll try to unhide everything. And and press GY to move inside. Press Ctrl space, go to the screen space reflection. And make it as 5 and let me try by 1. Yeah, now it's better. And roughness, I'm going to reduce it for a shiny look. I'm going to make it more shiny. Yeah. Now our frame with glasses ready. I press Ctrl space and press 0. And camera lock view, I'm going to change alignment. I make it close this one. F12 to view the angle. Oops, it's not coming correctly. You can go for the camera. Press N on the keyboard and unlock the camera view. Select this and delete. Resolution option and go for the this angle I'm going to keep. I make it like this. Press F12 to view. Yeah, fine. Our one frame is ready. I'm going to add one more photo frame also in this. I save it once again. I unlock the camera view and select these everything. Top view. Shift D to duplicate. Sorry, Shift D to duplicate. GX to move one more side. And I'm going to change the photo of this to once again. I'm going to change. First, I open one more window. Go to the UV editor. Sorry, shader editor. And I press control space and I'm going to open one more image which is called I have saved as a human. Oops, it's getting saved for the both, so which is not required for us. What we have to do is control Z, press yes to save. Here, what is the why it's happened like this? Because the both the materials are same, so we have to add one more material for this, right? Like add a new material. Before that, we can do one thing. We can select this, copy, control space, and minus it. Apply the new material, make it as photo 2. And I press control space and control V to paste that. And I'm going to connect this and I'm going to change the paint to human. Now, for us, 2 photo is ready for us. Two photo is ready. Finally, our framework is complete. I press F12 to for rendering, and which one I have given is Eve rendering. This photo is frame and photo is ready for designing the purpose and for shops and movies, everything which can be used. If you like this video, share it with your friends and subscribe the channel. Bye bye.